Hello, everyone. Today, I'd like to introduce a creative idea that might surprise you with its simplicity. By using just a magnet and a copper wire bent into the shape of a spring, you can build a homemade antenna that feels both unusual and practical. What makes this approach so interesting is not only the way it functions, but also the mindset behind it. Taking two ordinary objects and transforming them into something that carries real purpose. Creativity often shows up when we look at common materials with fresh eyes, and this is a perfect example of that. It's not about fancy tools or expensive equipment, but rather about curiosity and the willingness to experiment. So, if you enjoy discovering unexpected uses for simple items, this little project may spark your imagination. Let's dive in and see what we can create together. After finishing the copper spring, I make sure to leave a short piece of wire extending from each end. This detail makes the next step much easier. Once the spring is placed correctly inside the hole of the magnet, I secure it with hot glue. The glue holds the spring firmly in place and prevents it from shifting or slipping out. It's a simple step, but ensures the whole structure stays stable and reliable. Paying attention to small details like this often makes the difference between something fragile and something that actually lasts. The next step is to prepare a small rectangular piece of wood to serve as the antenna's base. I carefully mark the right spot on the wooden surface, then position the magnet and copper spring assembly so it stands upright. Once everything is aligned, I secure it firmly with hot glue. In my hand right now is a coaxial splitter. This device is used to divide a single coaxial signal into multiple outputs, allowing us to connect and test several components at once. It's a simple but practical tool that keeps the setup organized while expanding the possibilities for experimentation. Now it's just a matter of adjusting the two copper wire ends, trimming or bending them to reach the proper standard length. Once they are aligned, I insert them into two adjacent ports on the coaxial splitter. This step is essential for linking the antenna to the splitter, ensuring a stable signal connection, and keeping the setup neat and well-structured. If you made it this far and find the video interesting, don't forget to hit like and subscribe. Your support is what motivates me to keep sharing more creative ideas in the future. The antenna assembly is now complete. The next step is to create a connecting cable that links this homemade antenna directly to the TV. This stage is essential as it transforms the project from a simple experiment into a practical device that can actually be put to use. In my hand is a piece of coaxial cable, and the connection process is actually very straightforward. Take one end of the cable, attach it to a straight-up connector, and plug it into the remaining port of the coaxial splitter we set up earlier. The other end of the cable should be fitted with a straight-F connector along with a 90-degree F connector, which will allow a direct and tidy connection to the TV. This method keeps the setup simple, secure, and well-organized. The steps are fairly simple, yet sometimes hard to explain fully in words. That's why I encourage you to keep your attention on the screen and follow my hands-on demonstration. Watching closely will give you a clearer picture and make it easier to repeat the process with accuracy. Hey, are you staying focused while I'm working on this? If there's anything you don't quite understand, feel free to rewind and watch it again or drop a comment below. I'll do my best to answer and make things clearer for you. And with that, we finished building the homemade antenna along with its dedicated connection cable. Everything is ready. So let's move on to the testing phase and see how it performs in practice. This is the moment when the idea finally turns into a real experience. At the moment, my TV isn't receiving any signal because it hasn't been connected to the antenna yet. But in just a moment, you'll see it in action. As soon as the homemade antenna was connected to the TV, the screen started displaying a signal within just 3 seconds. It's genuinely exciting to see everything work exactly as planned. From the copper wire spring, the magnet assembly, to the coaxial cable connected to the splitter. The process may seem simple, but it requires precision and attention to detail. Observing the signal appear on the screen highlights how even basic materials can be transformed into a device that truly functions. In terms of how it works, this DIY antenna operates on the principle of electromagnetic induction. The magnet combined with the copper wire spring creates a small circuit capable of receiving radio waves. When waves arrive, they induce a tiny current in the wire, which is then carried to the coaxial cable to the splitter and finally to the TV. The spring shape increases the effective surface area and helps resonate with certain frequencies, enhancing signal reception. It's a clear example of applying simple physical principles to create something practical without complex equipment. This experiment goes beyond just seeing a signal. It teaches patience, observation, and step-by-step refinement. If you've been watching and find this video engaging, don't forget to like to support my work. Subscribe to catch future creative projects and comment below with questions or your own ideas. Also, share this video with friends or anyone interested in DIY projects, because sharing helps everyone learn and experiment together. Remember, sometimes the simplest ideas using everyday materials can produce impressive results. Creativity doesn't always require expensive tools or advanced technology. By carefully observing, experimenting patiently, and applying basic physical principles, you can build something both fun and functional. I encourage you to try making your own version, adjusting it to your needs and skills. It's the best way to learn, enjoy, and develop your creative abilities. Finally, thank you for following the entire process. Keep joining me in future projects, and don't forget to interact so we can come up with even more exciting ideas together.